إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، all praise is due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek His aid and forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can mislead. And whomsoever Allah led astray, there is no guidance for him. I bear witness and testify that no deity worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his last messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to proceed, my brothers and sisters, there is a hadith reported in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad and the Sunan al-Imam al-Tirmidhi, and narrated by Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. In this hadith, Anas narrated from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that Prophet Muhammad said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يعني إذا أراد الله بعبده خيرا استعمله. It means if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants wants good to his servant, he will use him. So the companions asked the Prophet عليه السلام, وَمَا اسْتَعْمَلَهُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. What it means اسْتَعْمَلَهُ. So the Prophet said عليه الصلاة والسلام, يَسَّرَ لَهُ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا يَقْبِدُهُ عَلَيْهِ. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good to his servant, he will guide him to do a righteous deed, then he takes his soul to make the last thing he does before his death a righteous deed. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted good for his servant, he will make him successful and guide him to do righteous deed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may take his soul while he is doing the deed or immediately after that, after he finishes his deed, if Allah wants good for a servant. And Allah azza wa jal will want good for his servant if his servant is sincere and truthful in his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the person has a good relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he is sincere, if the person has a sound heart, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him successful and he will guide him to end his life with something good. So he may take him while he is worshipping or immediately after that. And there is another hadith. And this hadith is reported in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim and narrated by the mother of the believers, Aisha radiallahu anha. She narrated from the Prophet and said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحب لقاء الله أحب الله لقاءه ومن كره لقاء الله كره الله لقاءه. يعني whoever loves to meet with Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal will love to meet him. And whoever hates to meet with Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal will hate to meet him. So Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers, she said, everyone hates to die. Every person hates to die. So the Prophet said, alayhi salam, no, he didn't mean that. Because human nature, when you live, you want to live forever. You hate to die because you don't know what's going to happen to you after death. You are not sure if your deeds are accepted or not. You are not sure you succeeded and passed the test or not. So absolutely you will fear death, but not to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet ﷺ explained what he said, and he said, if the person did good in his life, so in the final moment of his life, he will see the angels of death. And the angels of death will bring to him good news, will bring to him glad tidings. So once he hears the result of his test, he will love to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he knows he will be honored in this meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah azza wa jal will love to meet him. And if the person found the result in the time of death, when he sees the angels of death in scary faces, and he will know that his meeting with Allah will not be good. That's why he will hate to meet with Allah, and Allah Azza Jal will hate to meet him too. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة، ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم. So in this verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those who said our Lord is Allah, that means those who accepted Islam and said La ilaha illallah, announced their loyalty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, testified for his oneness subhanahu wa ta'ala, then istaqamu means they put themselves on the straight path, following the guidance of the deen, the Quran and the sunnah. In the time of death, Allah said, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ The angels of death will come to them. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا So what is the message of the angels to them? Once the person is about to die, once he is waiting for his final seconds, he will see what nobody else is seeing. He will see the angels of death in front of him. What they will say to the good person, the believer, as Allah said in this verse, أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا Don't be afraid and don't be sad. When you see us for the first time, don't be afraid and don't be sad. لَا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ Glad tidings to you. The paradise is the glad tidings to you. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ As you was promised before. If you do good in dunya, you will go to Jannah. So this is the good news for you in the time of death, that you are about to enter al-Jannah. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ It means as we supported you in dunya, we will support you in akhirah. We helped you and guided you in dunya. The angels will say that. As we guided you in dunya and supported you in dunya, you will be supported in akhirah. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها and in آخرة in جنة you will have in it ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون everything you love everything you like you will get in جنة everything you will ask for Allah سبحانه وتعالى will give it to you so this يعني this verse it tells us that the end of the life is very important The end of your life is very important. And also there is a hadith, and this hadith is reported in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad and narrated by al-Bara ibn Azib, radiallahu anhu. He mentioned that Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam was walking in the funeral of a person from al-Ansar, from the people of Medina. And when the companions arrived to the graveyard, the Prophet alayhi salam commanded them to sit down. So each one of them sat down. Bara ibn Azib said, وَكَأَنَّ عَلَى رُؤُوسِنَا الطَّيْرِ يعني imagine a person if he's sitting down and he have a bird standing on his, in his, above his head. He doesn't move his head. Everybody is giving the Prophet ﷺ the undivided attention. And the Prophet ﷺ started to explain the end of the life of a righteous person and the end of the life of a bad person. So he said عليه الصلاة والسلام إن العبد الصالح إن كان في انقطاع من الدنيا ولحاق بالآخرة يرى ملائكة بيض الوجوه كأن وجوههم الشمس ويقف ملك الموت عند رأسه فيقول أخرجي أيات الروح الطيبة إلى روح وريحان ورب راض غير غضبان So the Prophet said عليه الصلاة والسلام The righteous person when he is about to die he will see the angels of death with beautiful faces he will see them with beautiful faces. And the angel of death will come beside his head to call his soul to get out to the mercy of Allah and his paradise. So the person in his lifetime and before the soul gets out of the body, he will hear that. He will hear the result of his life. He will be told that he is one of the people of Jannah. So in this second, the soul will come out of the body in very easy way. In a very easy way. كَقَطْرَةُ الْمَاءِ مِنْ فِيِّ الثِّقَاءِ The Prophet said, as you put a drop of water from a bottle in a cup, the water goes in a very easy way. So the soul will get out in a very easy way. Then the angels of death will take the soul and put it in a coffin from al-Jannah. Then they will take the soul up to heaven. In the way, they will see angels. There are always angels between earth and heaven. between earth and sky. So the angels who are between the earth and the heaven will smell a good smell, and they will ask the angels of death, what is the name of this soul? Who is he? So the angels of death will give them the best name this person used to like to be called with. Even if you have a nickname, they will call you by your nickname, the name that you like to be called with. Then they will arrive to the first sky, and they will knock the door, because Allah built skies. It's a building, and it has doors, and the angels are security at the door. So the angels of death will seek permission and knock the door. The believer will be allowed to go to the first heaven. And in the first heaven, those who live in the first heaven, above the first sky, they will make funeral for him from the first heaven to the second. Then they will take permission to go to the second, from the second to the third, from the third to the fourth, up to above seven heaven. The angels of death are taking the soul with the book of the deeds of this servant. And above the seven heaven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will announce that he is pleased with his servant. He is pleased with his servant, and he accepted his deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the angels to put the book of this righteous person in Iliyin. Iliyin is like the library of the people of Jannah. Your book of good deeds will be left there. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell the angels of death to take the soul back to earth. ثم أعيدوه إلى الأرض فإني منها خلقتهم وفيها أعيدهم ومنها أخرجهم تارة أخرى. Allah will tell the angels, سبحانه وتعالى, take the soul of my servant back to earth. I have created them from earth, and I will return them back to earth, and in the day of judgment I will resurrect them from earth. So the angels of death will bring the soul back while the people are walking to the graveyard. You will be carrying the body, and the angels are carrying the soul. And once you put the body inside and complete closing the graveyard completely, in a way Allah only knows how, the angels will enter the grave and return the soul back to the body. And then they will ask this person three questions. What is your Lord? Who is your Lord? And what is your religion? And what is your belief in the man that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent to you? So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with his servant, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enable him to answer the questions. We're not going to answer the question from our memory. We will answer the questions from our heart. So the person will say, my Lord is Allah, my religion is Islam, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is my messenger. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell this person in his grave to look to his left side. When he look to his left side, he will see place in hellfire, and they will tell him, this will be your place if you disbelieved in Allah. But since you believed in Allah, look to your right side. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show him his place in Jannah. Then Allah azza wa jal will make his good deeds to appear to him in a form of a creature, of a man with beautiful face and beautiful smell and clean clothes. So that the deceased in his grave will ask the man and tell him, who are you? I see glad tiding in your face. So he will tell him, I am your good deed. I came for you, for your comfort in your grave. Then the person in his grave will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to start the day of judgment. He will enter Jannah. So he will be told, not now. Sleep in your grave, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him enjoy his sleeping in his grave until the day of judgment. The opposite of that to the one who was against God subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, against the prophets, against the religions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the time of his death, he will see the angels in very scary faces. And when the angel of death call his soul to get out, his soul will resist. So it will be taken by force. Then it will be put in a coffin from hellfire. And when they take the soul to the first heaven, the angels who are between earth and the sky will smell a bad smell. And they will ask the angels of death, who is this person who has bad smell? So the angels will name him by his worst names that he used to be called with in his lifetime. Then they will take him to the first sky, and once they seek permission, they will deny permission. They will be denied permission to enter the heaven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not allow a disbeliever, whoever he is, to enter his kingdom. He will be returned back from the first heaven. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will announce that he is displeased with his servant. And he will command the angel to take him back to earth as he created him from earth. He decided to return him back to earth and to resurrect him from the earth for the day of judgment. Then when people put the body in the grave, the angels of death will enter the grave and return the soul. And then he'll be questioned by the angels of Allah, who is your Lord? What is your religion? What is your belief about the man that Allah Azza wa Jal had sent to you? So the person, because he used to be against Allah, he will not be successful to answer. He will be scared and he will say, ha ha, la adri, I don't know, I don't know. In one of the narrations, he will say, سَمِعْتُ النَّاسَ يَقُولُونَ قَوْلًا فَقُلْتُ بِمِثْلِ قَوْلِهِمْ. I heard the people were saying something, so I said just like them. You know why he is saying this answer? Because he doesn't want to take any responsibility for any answer. He has doubt about anything and everything. So he will say, I heard that the people were saying something, so I said just like them. So he want to say, I'm not responsible if it is correct or not. Because he lived his life upon doubt. He will die upon doubt. And he will answer based on the doubt of his heart. So my brothers and sisters, when I brought this subject to you, because Ramadan is about to end. Ramadan did not end yet. Is about to end. And everything has beginning, will have end. As your life and my life, our life started and it will end, right? And it is very important to take advantage of every part of it. To invest it in our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to invest it for the future of us after death. So before you lose the final days of Ramadan, try to take advantage. Because maybe this Ramadan is your last Ramadan. You don't know if you're going to live to next one or not. And as Prophet Muhammad said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you want to seek the reward of Laylatul Qadr, be active in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, in the last 10 days of Ramadan. He did not say, focus on one night only. So tonight you have the Khatm al-Quran. Sheikh Abdullah Kamil will finish the Quran tonight. And you will see the masjid as, and you never seen it before. You will see the masjid, people are crowded above each other. I don't know why. And then tomorrow, we're not going to find a lot of people here. We have only 4 or 5 lines. Because people think it's just about reciting the last page of the Quran. I don't know who taught us that. Who taught us it's about to recite the last page of the Quran? No, it's not that. You need to be active here tonight, and you need to be active tomorrow if tomorrow we have Taraweeh, and to keep being active to last the second of this month. Maybe this night, the coming night, is the night of Laylatul Qadr. Nobody knows, right? Maybe the next one, also nobody knows. All the nights in the last 10 nights are nominated to be the night of Laylatul Qadr, and Allah is the only one knows which one is Laylatul Qadr. So don't come active tonight and say goodbye to the masjid from tomorrow morning. No, stay active up to the end of the month and take advantage. Renew your repentance to Allah. Keep saying the remembrance of Allah. Keep reciting the Quran. Keep donating money. Keep fasting. Keep praying the night prayer. Up to the last second until it is announced that tomorrow is no Ramadan. And after graduation from Ramadan, it's a different talk. We will talk about it later, inshallah. But what I'm trying to tell you today, make the end of your life is the best part of your life. And make the end of your Ramadan is the best part of Ramadan. For instance, the day of Jum'ah is a great day. But the best hour in Jum'ah is the last hour in the daytime. There is a supplication. If you make it in this hour, Allah will never return it. The Prophet said, there is an hour in the day of Friday. If you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything, He will give it to you. And the majority of the scholars are saying this hour is the last hour of the day. And also the best part of the night is the last part of the night when Allah descends to His servant, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to answer the supplications of those who supplicate and to forgive those who ask for His forgiveness and bestow his mercy upon those who ask for his mercy. Right or wrong? The best part is the end. So also when it comes to Ramadan, the best part of Ramadan is the end of Ramadan. The best part of Ramadan is the end of Ramadan. So don't do like other masajid. For instance, we have Khatm al-Quran yesterday in Masjid al-Tawheed in Jersey City. If you see the masjid, there is no parking lot in the street and the masjid is completely full. Next Taraweeh, you have half of the masjid. Where are the Muslims? They ended the Ramadan. We still have 3 days. We still have 3 nights. And maybe one of these 3 nights is Laylatul Qadr. So don't be deceived. And stay on the task until the final second. Because I will end with what I started with. The hadith. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good to his servant, he will make the end of his life a righteous deed to take his soul while he is doing it. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to forgive you, and if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to accept your supplications and your donations, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to accept your deeds in Ramadan, he will make the last part of your Ramadan the best of what you did. The best of what you did. Okay? So don't escape from the masjid after tonight, inshallah ta'ala. Inshallah ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. سبحانك اللهم ربنا بحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد. والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير.